Hello and welcome to Just Paint It. I'm Christina Watts, a multimedia artist in Prince George, BC, and today we are outside in the great outdoors and we're going to paint one of the more iconic images, the Nechako Cutbanks. If you'll notice when you look at the sky and the river, you know in your head that the river is blue and green, but it's actually the reflection of the sky on the river. And so if you want that to look realistic in your painting, what you have to do is paint the sky into your water, and that will give you a proper effect. Our painting today is going to be a very impressionistic piece of the Cutbanks, using wide brushes and palette knives. Now I'm going to add in the rolling hills that are in the backgrounds of the Cutbanks. And I want a nice green, sort of a darky green, and I'm hitting it with a mixture of yellow and this darker blue that I have. Now remember, because this is acrylic, this is going to dry darker, and that's what I want. I just want a nice darkish green, subtle green in the background. I haven't entirely mixed it because it's already got color variations right on my knife, and that's awesome. All right, I'm looking at the hillside and I see that we've got a faded green in the background. We don't want a lot of detail there because it makes it look off in the distance. And I'm going to slide this hillside right in here. Now that my rolling hills that are blurred and variegated color are off in the background and drying, I'm starting to look at the Cutbanks, and I know from picking up my palette knife and sort of angling it what kind of an angle that those Cutbanks need to be. So I'm going to cut in a bit of a line there. This is a guideline for me when I start to put in the paint, because now as I'm moving closer and closer, I need to be more detailed. The more detailed is going to show up and show that that part of the piece is front in the foreground of your painting, and it'll push these rolling hills to the background. Now I've got a bit of a line in for my Cutbanks, and what I want to do is move into the colors. I can see that they're like a sandy green over there. We are using an impressionistic painting, so any kind of color close to that is going to be what I'm going to mix here on my palette and use to slide in. So to get my sandy colors, I'm going to steal a little bit of that green with that blue, more of the yellow, some red, and I'm really just going to mix it till it's kind of a bit of a brown muddish color. And if I feel that that's pushing too dark, which it will dry dark, add some white. There we go. And now I'm going to grab all of that color on my knife and run it down the hill. As we move over to the trees, I'm going to add more blue to get to the greens that we see. Also, this side of the canvas is a little bit darker. You'll find that I'm always putting paint on my palette while I'm outside, particularly because it dries fast and I don't want to waste a lot of paint out here. It's nice to be able to layer out here, but sometimes you don't have that opportunity, so use a really thick paint on your palette knife. Adding some more green to the side. You see that? I made a mistake, but I like it, so I'm leaving it. Series of tapping and sliding. Carving with the knife, carving in the direction that you see the sand. I'm going to throw some white in while this is still wet, because this is going to dry really dark and I just want to kind of keep my colors. And I'm putting the white, the heaviest, where it is lighter on the side of the Cutbanks. So this cliff face here will get a lot more white. And we'll run it back down those little switchbacks. I don't know if anybody else gets up at 5 a.m. and hikes the Cutbanks, but the sun comes up right on the city in the nicest way, and it's just awesome to be up there watching everything wake up. And some more green. Sort of starting to build up my tree line. We're gonna add some heavier blues and darkers on this side over here where we see a lot of trees. Turning my knife as I go to use different sides of it really helps. Don't stay to this side, be loose, stay in control, but add those sides. Once I've built up some of the trees here, I'm going to move into paint pusher tools, what I like to call them. And we're gonna put in some darker points along the ridge here because there's shadows under the trees and that'll give this whole thing more depth. So just to build these trees up a little bit more. Try to make sure that they're not all the same height. Some bigger trees there. Using the tip of my palette knife to drag out some of these trees. And all I'm doing is really just pushing the paints up and down, giving a few lines here. And even along the ridge here, I might push some. See? Impressions of trees. I love them. They're fast. They're easy. I don't even have to look anymore. And if you want, you can go back into your whites here and move those around just a bit. If you find that this isn't big enough, move up a step, get yourself a bigger one. And I'm just gonna adjust some of this. The other thing you can do is actually wipe this stuff down a bit, because if you look over here, you can see that there's just a little bit of a faint line, and this is how you get some really nice reflections in your water, is just to drag it right into the water. We're going to start working the riverbank in. Now, we know that the river is kind of a green tone to it with blues and stuff, but because we need it to look kind of like the sky is reflected, we're going to be pushing it up a bit with a lot of white. I've got two different blues here, turquoise and blue, the same blues that I used in the sky. And I'm going to run some lines in and just pretty much do what I did with the Cutbanks, which is manipulate the paint with my palette knife, fully loaded, to carve the painting out. So whenever you have dark in a painting or red in a painting, you also want to have it somewhere else in the painting because the eye naturally wants to look around. So I've got this red up here. I'm going to bring it down here because it makes sense. It's reflecting in the water, but I'm also going to sort of hit a little bit right there in the corner. And I'm going to keep this horizon very straight, because even though that might not be straight, your eye on a painting wants it to be straight, and it also wants it to have a white line down here, which I'll put in later. I'm going to throw in a little bit of red because I just thinking that it needs a little bit of more variation down here. And it's also reflective of the cut bank that is above it. I've decided that this is okay for now. I'm gonna work into the trees and the horizon line, which means putting that white line that I talked about right along the edge there of the water. So I'm just loading the side of my blade and then I'm just gonna run it in. Now remember, a few choppy lines is totally okay. In fact, broken lines are better. And don't make them all the same. And if you want, you can even do some of these lines in the river, which will make it sort of look like there's light shining back off the top of it. All right, let's throw the trees right into the foreground on the bottom here, and then we'll do some grass work over top, and that will pretty much be the painting. Now I'm just kind of coming into the middle here, and I'm thinking need to elongate some of that down to nothing. Turning my knife as I go, using all the sides of the blade. I'm not gonna be able to put the winery in, which is unfortunate because that's pretty iconic here in Prince George now, but I might just visit it later on. We have a little bit of a road there going to the pulp mill in the background, so I'll just put in a little bit of a lighter line so you can sort of see it. And that was a bit much right here, but it's okay because I will fix it. I'm fixing that line up a bit. And I'm going to think about that. I think that I've got too thick of a line here. I'm going to wipe that out. These are all adjustments that happen as you're working in the piece, so, you know, don't be scared to put paint on your painting. I mean, what's the worst that can happen? You paint over it. I'm going to put some grasses over here so that you can see that there is a corner to this piece, and which is nice because your eye will focus around here this way through the painting in a nice little bit of an S. S designs are great in paintings, just like a diagonal is, because it just makes them, again, aesthetically pleasing. I'm gonna say this 1,000 times, but the way that you place your pieces in your paintings will ensure that it's interesting, that it works. And I'm going to throw some reds here because I've got quite a bit over there, but don't worry, this will get dry. We're working dark to light on the grass, so I'm going to start with dark, and then I'll paint over top some white. Red, green, blue, tapping it in, adding my white and my lights last here. And scraping. Okay, I made a couple other adjustments to this piece, and now I'm going to sign it. This time I'm signing by carving in. Enjoy the parks around Prince George and have yourself an artful day.